people important kaya ng araw? Yeah, important kaya. Than others, yeah. They were not wrong in naming me national artist. They must have had their reason. And now I'm beginning to see what the reason might be. But they believe in what I have written.
Dati, medyo nagkakaroon ako ng doubt sa writing ko. Nung mapasok ako sa klase niya, he pushed me to write. Parang nagkaroon ako ng tiwala sa sarili ko na what's it like? It's very funny. He's sharp. Yung marami siyang alam, tapos hindi ko alam yung sinasabi niya minsan. Marami siyang alam. He knows. He brings, he lives literature.
No, it doesn't change me. I'm focused, distracted, sabog. I'm sabog as a person. Although I always try to keep my appointments.
It is but right that Franz is national artist for literature. Without Franz, I think our literature in English would be poorer.
Zacarias Eugenio Francisco Aquino Arcellana was a certified Manila boy. He was born in Santa Cruz, Manila on September 6, 1916, the fourth boy of 18 children of Jose Arcellana and Epifania Aquino.
All childhoods are happy. If you had an unhappy childhood, you're especially unlucky. I think by definition, a childhood is a happy time. Normally, all childhood is happy.
He attended the Tondo Intermediate School. Tondo became the landscape of his youthful imagination. Teenage life in Torres High School added a new layer of experience for the future national artist. He became a staff member of the school paper called the Torres Torch. Among his circle of friends were writers making names for themselves in and out of campus.
There were published writers on campus already. Now, Cesar G. Reyes was a senior on the same campus. Lazaro M. Espinosa was maybe a junior. Yeah. And I was a very good friend of Lazaro. And, well, that's how it is, you know. Your friends write, you know, you want to write too. Everything that I have written is actually based on something in my life.
Interestingly, his drive to get published at age 16 was of a totally different motive.
I wanted to make an impression on a girl. That's the truth. I wanted to make an impression on a girl. When I published that story, suddenly I was real. I mean, I had identity. Yeah. And then after that, Lina. Manu Vivo, Frankie, and then Lina. Yeah. This girl's name is Lina. Frankie's not about me. It's about her best friend, Francisca.
The 1930s, which saw his passage from adolescence to manhood, was Franz Arcellana's most productive years, a time when he would produce the majority of the stories and poems that would make him a pillar in Filipino English literature. Although his writings in English may never make him popular among the masses, the themes and images he created are the self-same ones which engage the popular imagination.
I have two obsessions. Death, which is probably the most conspicuous, the most obvious, and my other obsession is sex. That's my other obsession. And the curious thing is this, no? These two things are really aspects of each other. It's like two-headed Janus. One head is death, and the other head is sex, and they belong to the same person.
He experienced censorship in 1933 for writing frankly about his own sexual experience when he published his own story under St. Veronica's Press.
He was an old man, his name was Ilagan. He owned this very famous printing press on Binondo called Ilagan and Sunga, two partners. So I went there, I had the 200 pesos to pay for the printing. He got my money, huh? This was a man maybe about 40, 45. And in 1934, I was 18. And you know what these guys said after he got my money? He got my money. And then he said, I cannot give you the copies of the magazine. He said, because the story there called The Story of Manhood is obscene. He said, no? And we can be arrested, he said. Huh? And fined anywhere from 500 to 1,000 pesos.
During the 30s, he spearheaded St. Veronica's Press, comprising the Veronicans, 13 writers who wanted to publish their experimental works in the quarterly paper called Expressions. Franz led a triple life during the 30s. He was a creative writer, he was a pre-med student, he was a newspaperman. Easily, the 30s were the best time of his life.
Because I think you know as well as I do that it's impossible to write or to live by writing well, no? Writing good. Although, I suppose I'm saying that if you can be a newspaperman, be a newspaperman. That's why the Japanese, I think they hate me, the Japanese, yeah. I feel it, you know. And I hate them too, yeah. Because if that thing hadn't happened, I'd probably be a much happier person, and my life would really be different. I probably would be a doctor now if the war didn't happen.
You wouldn't believe that we met in 1940, December. I was in the only all-women's debate at Villamore Hall, which is now the Supreme Court. We used to perform there as, well, all the best plays, all the best activities were in Villamore Hall. That was the plush theater. This was the first all-women's debate. You were all in evening dresses, three against three.
And he was in the opposite?
No, all women's. He was in the audience, a spectator. So he kind of liked my white lace dress, I suppose. I never came across a suitor like this, who would regale me with three roses a day and three chocolates, you know, three with poems yet, every day without fail. Maybe because he was writing a column, so he had funds then to sustain such. Even then, roses cost a lot from Baguio, those big yellow roses. But they were lovely, they smelled good. I liked them.
After World War II, Franz sought a career in the academe while he continued his work with the print media. He joined the UP English department and served as an advisor to the Philippine Collegian. He also became the director of the UP Creative Writing Center from 1971 to 1982.
Yeah. You know, I keep telling my class, no? If you write only for yourself, that's what I call masturbation. That is literary masturbation. Yeah. You don't just write for yourself. You write to be able to do some good.
As a person, he's wonderful to deal with. Yeah, because he knows literature is in his bones. He breathes literature, nah? And so he is very, very inspiring for anyone who have any dealing with him, nah? Especially if one is a writer.
He was the first ever professor in UP who gave me a one. So for that alone, I will remember him all my life.
With Franz, we had to take time to look beneath the surface, to see what's going on. He might stop you in the hallway, for example, in UP, and tell you something which might sound like an oracle from a prophet. And you will spend the next several days trying to figure out what exactly was Franz telling me. And maybe at some point it will occur to you. But that's Franz, and I think much of his artistry derives from that.
I think that after all is said and done, whatever talent I had in the beginning was a true talent. It was a true talent. It was a true gift that I got from God. And what have I done with it? Exactly nothing. Now I want to compensate. I want to make up for that.